Hey there! I'm Katie Cleveland, and this is Walking Together, a Christian parenting podcast. My education in early childhood development and social and emotional learning helps me to teach God's Word to kids each week, but I want you parents to be the main teachers of the faith to your kids. Join us each week as we explore topics that both kids and parents can use to build their relationships to God and with each other. Welcome back, everyone. This week, we're going to start a new segment around belonging and bullying. As a middle schooler, I was the target of bullying. There was a rumor that someone in the sixth grade had started in my class, and it caused me to shut down for a while as a preteen. I was afraid to talk to anyone in my class or try to make a new friend because I wasn't sure if they would be kind or cruel. Girls would also make fun of my hair or would try hiding things in it from time to time. I don't know if you know me, but I have a lot of hair. But I will say, even though those things happened to me, I still had it way easier compared to what some teenagers face today. I didn't have a phone, and I didn't have social media back then, so the bullying stopped when I got home. And there, I felt safe. But we can't push all the blame on phones and technology, can we? We have to teach our kids how to guard their hearts while also treating others with respect. We are all made in the image of God. Imagine how we would treat each other and see ourselves if we really understood that. So let's talk more about the difference between bullying and not feeling included. Bullying has become a trigger word in a lot of schools, and sometimes I think we get confused about what it actually is. The definition of a bully is a person who seeks to harm, intimidate, or coerce. I sometimes think that when a child feels left out, they might see it as being bullied, but it's not the same. I also experienced feeling not included, or not feeling that you belong. And you know, this is something that we have to understand the difference, because one needs intervention from a trusted adult because the child could be in danger. Like danger in a physical, emotional, or a mental way. Bullying definitely requires school and parents to get involved. But feeling left out or hearing your child say nobody likes me might be something as a parent you want to help your child talk through and figure out a way to solve it themselves. This is something that you may not want to intervene on unless you find it absolutely necessary. Your call to action this week is to stop and assess before you call someone out for bullying. Ask your child these questions. Did you not feel safe? How long has this been going on? What do you think we can do about it? Leave me a comment in the comment box about other good questions you can ask to learn more about the situation before you talk to the teacher. Kids, if you see me this week, tell me about your thoughts around bullying. How have you handled it or could handle it? In the next 5 episodes, we're going to cover what you as parents can do when your child is being bullied or feeling left out. God cares for your child and wants them to feel loved and safe. This is Katie Cleveland. Join me next week as we talk about what it means to feel like you belong and what you can do about it when you don't. I hope to see you next time. God bless.